If you're watching this video, you probably already know what a function is and how to do some mathematical operations. This video is about convolution. And just like addition, subtraction, multiplication, or division are mathematical operations, convolution is a mathematical operation. But instead of numbers, we are going to use functions. For example, suppose we have the following two functions. The sum of f and g is equal to this. The product of f and g is equal to this. And the convolution of f and g is defined as follows. Multiply the function f of x with the function g of t minus x, and take the integral of this product with respect to x. If we set a variable with a high enough positive number, like 1000 for example, we can approximate this integral with a Riemann sum. Differential of x is going to be equal to b minus a divided by n. Therefore, we can approximate this integral in the following way. Convolution is a subject that must be put in context. What we are seeing on the screen is the mathematical definition of convolution, the convolution of a function f and a function g. However, in signal processing, for example, a convolution is an operation between two finite signals. A finite signal is simply a function that's zero everywhere except on a given interval. This interval will also be the interval of integration of the convolution. The function g is also a finite signal. For this particular example, a is equal to minus 1, b is equal to 1, c is equal to 0, and d is equal to 1, and this is how it looks. Here is the function f. Here is the function g. And here is the convolution of f and g. Now suppose that f and g are discrete functions. Since the discrete equivalent of integration is summation, the convolution of f and g can be written as a sum of products. If we assign the following values, for example, this is what we get. The convolution of f and g at t equal to minus 1, at t equal to 0, at t equal to 1, and finally at t equal to 2. Outside of these values, the convolution is 0. If we analyze the word convolution, we will realize that it is similar to the word evolution. We can define evolution as the development of something over time. So if we have a function f of t, we could say that the function evolves as t increases. Based on this idea, we can define convolution as the evolution of a function integrated with another function. So far, what we have seen is the convolution of two functions of one variable. The convolution of two functions of two variables is defined below. Let's say n and m are very large values. So we can rewrite this double integral as a double sum in the following way. For example, suppose we have this function and this other function. The convolution of these two functions is defined in this way. Thank you for watching.